So this is just going to be a really quick and simple video that shows you how to import a single private key into the Coinomi wallet on your mobile. And if you haven't already done so, just hit subscribe and that'll help you to stay in the loop about content I make that helps you to find your way in the hostile and crazy environment that is cryptocurrency. So there's a number of reasons why I might do this. Maybe you bought some crypto at a Bitcoin ATM or something like that, and it basically just spat you out a paper receipt with a private key on it. Maybe someone gave you some crypto on a paper wallet as a gift, or maybe you want to access some funds on a BIP39 paper wallet or even a hardware wallet for some reason. Though it's important to understand, there are also reasons why you might not want to do this, in that when you sweep private keys in the way I'm going to show you with Coinomi, you actually pay a small amount of fees for each transaction, for each private key you sweep. So if you've been using a wallet for some time and have a whole bunch of different addresses with funds on them, you might actually be better off importing the entire seed into something like Electrum. Bearing in mind that when you import your entire seed like that, you are losing a lot of the additional security that a hardware wallet or a paper wallet gives you. But there are some situations in which you're going to want to do this. So the first step obviously is to get the Coinomi wallet. It's open source and it's available on Android and on iOS, and it's free. It's a great multi-currency wallet, good place to start if a mobile wallet is what you're looking for. So download that, set it up, and make sure you add an account for the coin type that you want to sweep into Coinomi. The next step is to load up your seed in a tool like Ian Coleman's BIP39 tool, but making sure that when you do so, you're not just using your internet connected desktop environment, but you are using an air gapped, that is not connected to the internet computer. And I would recommend an amnesic environment. So that's something like Tails Linux that basically wipes everything every time you reboot. And I've made videos that look at how to set up an environment like that. It's actually easier than you think and can be done using free tools and a USB stick. So basically, once you're in your air-gapped environment, you just want to open up Ian Coleman's tool and punch in your seed. And basically, if you have a BIP39 passphrase, so again, that's not the PIN number you use to access your hardware wallet. That's not the password for Ledger Live or anything like that. This is your BIP39 passphrase. So if in doubt, just leave that blank. But for this demo, I'm just going to use one for some previous videos I've made. So basically, for this video, we just want to sweep some Litecoin. So we just select Litecoin in the coin drop down. So there's Litecoin. So basically we just scroll down and we get a bunch of addresses. Now, the only thing you will need to know is what account type you are coming from. So if you had, say, a legacy wallet type, you're going to want to select BIP44. If you have no idea, this is probably the one you've been looking for if you've crypto has been there for a few years. BIP49 is what's going to be called SegWit for most wallets, and BIP84 is going to be what's called native SegWit. So we'll just sweep the BIP44 one for this demo because the process is the same for all of them. So basically just scroll down, you can see all the addresses you want, and you can basically just put your cursor over the address and you'll actually see a QR code that represents that. But if you move your cursor over onto private key, it'll show you a QR code that represents the private key, and that's what we're going to sweep into Coinomi. So basically you open the account type you want in Coinomi and basically just click the little dots in the top corner, say sweep wallet, and basically you can choose which account it's going to go into. You basically click the little button for the QR code and then you can scan it. You just say next and it'll basically work out what the funds that are in there. It'll work out the fee and you can just say confirm, and that'll actually just broadcast the transaction onto the blockchain, and after a little while that will appear in your account. One important gotcha you need to know with this is that when you sweep addresses from a paper wallet like this, or sweep an individual private key from a wallet, basically if you do that just to spend part of the funds using Coinomi, what's left doesn't just stay on that old private key, but rather will get sent to a change address in Coinomi. So if you do want to, you know, return a portion of your unused funds back onto a paper wallet, you'll need to select a fresh public address on your paper wallet to send those funds back to when you're done. There's really nothing else to it, so there you go. Thanks for watching, I hope that was helpful. Hit like if you think that other people would find this video useful, and hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make that helps people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. If you have any questions about this video or a topic that you'd like me to cover, just leave a reply.